Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. This is Crazy Kitsune Gaming with another episode of Garden Warfare 2. And today we're going to be going over, I think, the last mode that I haven't gone over yet. Technically, the last two modes. Today we're going to be going over Turf Takeover, also known as Gardens and Graveyards, and Herbal Assault. Yeah, these are technically two different game modes, but if you go through the multiplayer portal, they're both smashed into one and called Turf Takeover. So basically, these are modes where you sort of need to go in and either attack or defend a specific point. And there are also, when you capture that point, there are about six of them in total that you need to take, so you'll need to go and keep going forward through the map and capturing or defending as best you can the different points. And at that last point, there is usually a special objective specific to the map that is usually vastly different than just capture a point. So that is the mode we're going to be going over today. Now, keep in mind with this mode, both in Gardens and Graveyards and Herbal Assault, there are way less maps because they actually have different maps for this mode in particular. Because this really wouldn't work with a lot of the other maps. Like, you're not gonna play this on something like Frontline Flats. There's really no way to do that, to really smash the kind of gravity and scope of this mode into a smaller map. Which is why they have these bigger ones, but there are far less of them. So this is what we're going to be doing today. And I figure we may as well start it on the only map you can start on, Great White North. Because if you go into the multiplayer portal and try to choose mixed mode, they will make sure that you start off on Turf Takeover with Great White North. So then, let's go ahead and hop through the portal. And yeah, I'm gonna be going in as Cactus this time, because I'm gonna be honest, Turf Takeover is pretty much one of my favorite game modes. It's up there with Gnome Bomb and Garden Ops. And Cactus, in Garden Ops, not sure if I mentioned it on my video in Garden Ops, Cactus is really good because her defensive focused abilities are pretty much at their best in that mode. And that is a similar case for the Turf Takeovers. So yeah, let's just set up a bit of a defense here. So yeah, this point, we're going to be needing to defend this with our lives. Nothing else really matters other than keeping this point safe. And that is the most victim engineer I've ever seen. I think the All-Stars are gonna get him back up though. So yeah, basically this is kind of the mode. Now, if we lose this point, we'll need to go to a new one, get ourselves ZPG'd in the face, and have to adapt to a completely new area that we'll need to defend. Come on, you can do it, Split P. Or you can just go into Gatling. Really, your priorities are a little misplaced. Ah yes, I could revive the Cactus, or use the ability that's just going to get me killed. Get out of here, foot soldier. So yeah, this circle, the green circle, we need to keep the zombies out of that as best we can. Anytime that they have more zombies in than we have of plants, they are going to make capture progress. As you can see on the little bar, they already have a little bit of it, so we should stop situations like this from happening where they are on top of the point. This could be a really quick loss. Wow, this could be super quick. Come on. Guys, we can do better than this. This is not how we're trained. Corn, do not run out of the point, because see, now that there's no plants in there, they are capturing, and it's not good. Wow. We actually lost it. Don't you love when the AI teammate does not defend very well? So yes, unfortunately, now that this point is taken, we cannot take it back. We just need to retreat to the last point. Even if we somehow killed off all the enemies, they actually don't let you recapture points. They will let you get killed by Super Ultra Balls, because once the point is captured, then they will immediately spawn the zombies there, on that new point. Now, the good thing is, each time they capture a point, they have a little bit less time to capture. They start off with about 7 minutes to take that first point, but this one, they only have, like, 4. Wow, what, that foot soldier really should have just stayed back and tried to heal up a bit. Engineer, where are you going? Where are you going? Where are you going? Oh, I know where you're going. You're going to the grave. That's where you're heading. Alright. Hello there, All-Star. That was very unlucky for him. Alright, so now this is the point we need to protect. Now, fun fact, each of the maps kind of have their own little, like, mini-story to them. It's like their own little slight narrative to them. I think this map in particular, Great White North, was actually added back in a DLC where they kind of, shortly after it was released, had a very special boss hunt, kind of like Captain Smasher's Curse, where you had to fight a Yeti. And that Yeti is actually the one the zombies are trying to free in this particular mission. Alright, there we go, got him. Also, fun fact, when this mode was first released in Garden Warfare 1, there wasn't really a version of it where the zombies were on the defense. It used to be just gardens and graveyards, which is the version of it where the plants are defending. There was no Herbal Assault in Garden Warfare 1. Also, something I kind of forgot to mention earlier. Yeah, Garden Warfare 1, it's now 10 years old. Honestly, like, happy birthday, Garden Warfare 1. We're past its birthday now, but yeah, kind of crazy to think that that game is now that old. Kind of makes me feel old, even though, I mean, I'm not a million years old, but come on. Although, seeing this All-Star is getting quite old real quick. But yeah, you know, I really should do a video on Garden Warfare 1 one of these days. It's just one of those, I don't really like it as much as this one. I think Garden Warfare 2 is basically better than Garden Warfare 1 in almost every conceivable manner. I really think so. But I should probably go do a video on Garden Warfare 1. It feels weird to play the sequel of a game and not play its original. Now, I've played Garden Warfare 1. I've just never really shown it off on the channel because it doesn't, in my opinion, hold as much entertainment value. Now then, we should probably stop going off on tangents and actually explain what's going on here with the mode, because, oh boy, that's a lot of zombies. They aren't really seeming to let up. See, usually they have to go back to their initial respawn spot, but we have a certain situation here. See, Engineer has 3 abilities in most modes. He has the Bolt Blaster that he can use in private play, and usually he has his stun grenade and also his jackhammer he can use. In this mode, and also in Garden Ops, he has a 3rd ability, and that is to build portals at certain locations. And I think this is, yep, they have a portal back there. Now, see, in Garden Ops, these portals aren't too bad. They have a lot more locations they can show up in, but they don't come up as often, and they only spawn in brown coats. Here, though, in Turf Takeover, yeah, that's entire zombie heroes that are coming through the portals. And engineers can also set up these special versions of the rocket bots, that are called defender bots, that actually do far more damage than the rocket bots, and they can set up usually around 3 of them near the portals. Do not imp punt, thank you. Aw, he had that face on him. He had the face of an All-Star who was about to imp punt. I'm so glad he didn't. Ah. Yeah, you don't have scientists now. You're foiled. I could die here. Ouch. What even got me? Sporty. Okay. Gotta be honest, it looked like the foot soldier was the one who did it. So, yeah, do watch out for that. If you feel like there's a ton of zombies coming from a particular direction, That probably means that they have a teleporter up. Oh, hey, I'm actually on the screen. Yeah, hi there. Wahoo! Alright, plants defended. So, they captured a point, but we defended the other five. Now then, I think that means we're gonna have to go on a more offensive operation with the Herbal Assault. I got, a lot of boast. 45 kills. 45. My favorite number. I think my favorite weapon has 45 in the name. Now then, let's go to Herbal Assault. And let's go with... let's go Zomburbia. Now here's the thing. Being on the attacking team is always more difficult. Especially the attacking team on plants. It is very difficult, so I am sorry if I don't outright win this match. We will do our best, but I make no guarantees whatsoever. Oh, also, just for anyone who's curious, yes, I will be doing the playthrough of the zombie campaign rather shortly. I think this will be basically the last video I make before I finally move on and do that zombie campaign. So then, finally, people can stop, complaining about it. Speaking of zombies, let's go ahead and switch teams. Like, could you maybe don't try sticking me on zombies? That would be kind of nice. Alright, Colonel Corn, you're up, because I think you are way better for attacking than Cactus. Now then, this map has a few things that are different from most. See, like I said, every map is a little bit different. Here, the zombies actually get a little bit of extra defense with these very large rocket bots up there that actually have larger and more damaging rockets than most of them. And they also have a tad bit more health. Alright then. So, kind of the opposite of what we were doing earlier. We need to go in and capture that point. And that foot soldier just shot a sandbag with a ZPG. I mean, you really killed that sandbag, but like, was it necessary? Alright, there you go, Sunflower. Get that beam going. Get that beam going. Now, something to remember when capturing points in Turf Takeover is area of effect weapons are very effective for getting enemies off the immediate point. Kind of part of the reason I chose Corn is if I could not get killed by an engineer, I could actually use Butter Barrage and deal a little bit of damage to enemy that's on that point. Now, some enemies will try to avoid the point, but then they're kind of not defending it anymore. Alright, get rid of the All-Star. Man, they're very, very tanky. Okay. Currently they have three enemies over there. Butter Barrage. And we are capturing. Oh dear, that's a Z-Mech. Alright. I complete a whole quest, alright. Oh, I missed my Husk Comp. I mean, I kind of deserved to, but like, come on. Just let me be cheesy for once. I mean, you guys are so cheesy. I was killed with the Robo Stomp. Like, come on, the zombies get to have so many different cheesy abilities. You're really telling me I can't use my Husk Copperoni and cheese? That's so annoying. It's so flavorful. So tasty. It's like cheddar, but then, like, also better. Alright, what's going on over here? We really have an engineer here. Oh, and he's kind of made up his mind. At least he's retreating. I would rather him do that than be annoying. Oh, wait, no, he does want to actually attack. Why would you do that? Now, since we have captured that point back there, we are now going to spawn in further up and closer to the map. But again, kind of like what the zombies dealt with when they were trying to capture our points, we now have less time to capture this next one. Oh, hello, pirate. Alright. All-Star went down nice and smooth. Now there's another one. This is when you think the pain is over. They show you what happiness could look like, and then they stick another All-Star in your face. Get rid of that rocket bot. Okay. They currently are very... Oh, no. This is a very special bot they have here. Get rid of this trash. No. That is a uplink bot, and you want to destroy them as fast as cornally possible, because they will constantly call in orbital bombardments, and these bombardments are incredibly devastating. You can just get hit by a couple of them, and that's it. You will just die. And they can take out entire crowds all at once. So those uplink bots, I think they're called, needs to be taken out very quickly. In fact, I think I've explained this before because I've seen them in the Gnome Bomb episode as well. But it bears repeating. Those uplink bots are probably the most deadly bot you could possibly deal with. Far more deadly than a go-to-fight scientist. You're getting husked off. Sorry. You're a super brain. You deserve no respect. You get a salute, and that's about it. Okay, I've been where you've just been, All-Star. I really have. Hello there, other All-Star. You're now other dead All-Star. Let's get rid of all these fences. Yeah, fun fact, some maps actually have quite a bit of fencing. These will actually block the first shot that goes into them. And also kind of give enemies a bit of cover. Sometimes you can use them to your advantage. I personally find it's best to get rid of fencing like that just quick as possible. Because I feel like the AI is way better at using it than any player could ever be at using the fence cover. Okay. See, we've got a decent little attack force. Why can't the AI always coalesce into a group like this? Oop, hold on. Not the best husk hop, but you know, it kind of didn't really get the job done. It didn't save me from the couch potato bolt blaster. Oh, P-Shooter, you can do it. Or not. I mean, I would have stayed and tried to get that revive. Now, fun fact. Kind of like how the engineers can set up teleporters, roses can set up these portals. Assuming that they're actually any closer to the point. I mean, it gets us to the side. Gets us to the side where there's both a Z-Mech and All-Star, and you are seriously missling madnessing me right now. Oh dear, okay. Sunflower, Sunflower. Madam Sunflower, Madam Sunflower.
I need heals! What are you doing? Please?
Yes, I understand there's the Super Brains. I'd be better off dealing with them with health. Thank you. Alright, dead pirate. Whoa, that ZP genie very nearly hit me. Okay, buddy, you are paying for that one. Nah, you're not getting away with that one. Really, you're gonna go into Batty Blaster. Give us a break, please. Thank you. Oh, who set up with Mr. Flamey up here? Give it a break. Oh, now Sunflower's dead. Hold on. Get her back in the fight. Corn, what are you doing? Wait, Corn got that revive? Okay. The Sunflower's alive, that's all that matters. Are we even gonna capture this? See, this is the thing, it is really hard to capture. I mean, I've only got it on normal difficulty. It shouldn't be that ridiculous, but it is. When did you get in here? Who invited you, Foot Soldier? Oh, come on. Heals, thank you so much, Sunflower. I need this so badly. Oh, no, no, keep healing. Okay, we've captured. Good, good, good. Oh, criminy. I really just got conned by the freaking gravity grenade. Okay, we captured, and as you can see, it spawned us back here, so life is good. Believe me, it is way better to try and capture if possible than keep yourself alive. Because it doesn't really matter if you die, if you end up capturing. Because then you can just respawn yourself right on top of that point. Oh yeah, this is a part of the map where there's a nice little parade going on. Yeah, we're gonna kind of ruin it. By the way, there's actually a gnome here if you shoot this wall. Yeah, it's a not very well hidden gnome. I feel like you could accidentally sneeze and run into that one, but you know, it's there. Oh, that's a lot of zombies. Oh, that's a lot of zombies. Oh, that is too many zombies, some would say. Super Brains, what are you doing using your beam? Super Brains does actually have a nice little long-range beam attack, but it doesn't really do a whole lot of damage. But sometimes the AI does consider it as a valid weapon, and so sometimes they'll try and sit back and use it, and it's like, what are you doing? You have the IQ of a ham sandwich. Okay. A little bit of capturing. Not enough healing. No, that's a cactus, not a sunflower. What if we had a sun cactus or something? That would be nice. Oh, I should have reloaded earlier. Get rid of the engineer. Get rid of the engineer. Oh, shoot. He got some foot soldier up. Yeah, get rid of the foot soldier. I'm dead anyway. I'm probably dead anyway. Oh, could I maybe use this Dr. Heals? No. No. I was killed by mittens on kittens. Yeah. Oh, sunflower. Sunflower. You could res me. It is an option. It's a thing you're capable of. Thank you, Happy Flopsy. I mean, the Happy Flopsy made my Flopsy happy, so. That just sounded so weird. Oh, Z-Mac. Nope. No. Oh, real. Well, how come my husk hop ain't working? Come on. I played that like such a scumbag, and I still died. I killed my cat and Sparkles. Man. It ain't going too well. Yeah, I feel like each point is designed to be a little bit harder to capture than the last. So you eventually get to this point where it's just so hard to keep on keeping on in this mode. Oh, just look at how well they're stacked on top of that. See, you don't really get that in PvP. At least in PvP, they kind of spread out, and sometimes you can make vague amounts of progress on capturing. But here, there's just, they leave nothing to the imagination. Oh, absolutely nothing to the imagination. Who is actually seeing me back here? Oh, nope. Oh, really? You have to send a whole little squad out here. Oh, you, okay, that's cute. Set up an uplink bot to try and kill me. Uplink bot does have a slow firing rate, by the way. It does need to charge up. The danger of uplink bot is anytime it's not being seen. Okay, we're capturing. Never mind. We could be capturing. Yes, okay, that's perfect. Scientist, nobody asked you to be here. Pirate, no. Ugh. By the engineer again as well. That's what really hurts. Yeah, did I mention that we are probably not gonna win? Yeah, it feels, at least on plants, very difficult to actually win this mode. I've gotta be brutally honest. It is just an absolute trial. Come on. Get out of here. And the thing is, they, especially with this point, they just respawn so close. Literally, the zombie's respawn point is a few meters back from where you're actually having to fight. So yeah, you can kill one. That's nice, but they'll probably get a new one really quick. And you're really hitting me with double super brains. Yeah, killed by last zombie hero. Something tells me this is gonna be our last chance to capture. 20 seconds left. No, it's not happening. We could get, like, two extra citrons here right now, and I don't think it would be enough. I mean, please, team, prove me wrong. No, get out of here. Okay. We could go into overtime. As long as I'm standing here, we're in overtime. Come on, guys, come on. Come on, guys, come on. Okay, wow. Man, this mode is a little bit hard, isn't it? Yeah. No. You do not get to taunt me. No. Not allowed. Okay, on to the next point. At least they give us 5 minutes for this one. We are actually kind of close now. We're actually so close to winning. Although the problem with this point is there is such a massive open field. Because the capture point is this circular enclosed area. And yeah, all this area around for the enemy to shoot at us. Get rid of that all-star. Yeah, they're actually coming out and being a little offensive. I kind of really don't know how the AI works. I don't know if they have a proper hive mind AI. They're definitely aware of each other during combat. They sometimes strategize with each other. But I feel like they don't do it as hard as they could. See, like, they're reviving each other. The zombies are aware that there's a scientist who set up a Dr. Heals there. So, they definitely have some knowledge of what each individual unit is doing. I'm just not sure how powerful it is. Oh, hello, foot soldier. Oh, that's a lot. That's a lot. Oh, I'm dying. I don't think I've quite seen my health bar vanish that quick. That's a new record. Oh, dear. At least a rose has a portal up, but that could be... This last point could be the final wall that stops us. Yeah, they have 3 zombies in there right now. They've got a bunch of zombies around it. I know there's a Z-Mech to my left. I want to get rid of the pirate first. Okay, Z-Mech can now be dealt with. Okay, Dr. Heals, get out of here. That thing has been keeping so many zombies alive, it's not funny. Super brains, seriously. Oh, double scientist, no. Get out of here. That's not cool. That's not fancy. It's tacky. That's what that is. How are you gonna have 2 scientists healing a super brain? Do you want to make an unstoppable melee combat? Come on. Very sorry I blocked somebody's shuck shot. Okay, there we go. Come on. We just had a guy in there. Come on. We just had a guy in there. There you go, Rose. There you go. The record shows that Rose finally did something helpful for the team. Never before seen footage of a Rose being helpful. Get rid of the foot soldier. Yes! We're on to last point. And ironically, the last point is not much easier than everything else we've done so far. Okay. So, each last point is a little bit special. This one in particular is basically, the mission is to sort of ruin this kind of graduation party for all of the zombie recruits that are here. So basically we're going to do that by taking their toilet paper and using it against them. I mean, like, this is like a post-COVID era. Like, that's a heinous crime. We are truly, absolutely in violation of the Geneva Convention. Or, should we say Geneva Suggestion, because, we are definitely TPing the statue. I hope you know. Okay, so, other than that first bit, there are 5 sections to deal with. Actually, only 4. We have the library we need to deal with, then the gallery, which in my opinion is the hardest to actually take over, and also the dining hall. There's also the central statue, which, in... this private play against the AI, the center statue is always the first to go down. But if you're playing PvP, the central statue is actually a pretty difficult boy to go after. Now, keep in mind, as you take out more and more of the rooms, it will get harder and harder to get rid of each new one. So, like, for example, if the dining hall goes down, that means they will spend more units to go and defend the gallery, because now the dining hall doesn't need to be worried about. So it means that you can run to a situation where the gallery is the last room, except it's the easiest for the enemy to defend. So get rid of the gallery first if you can. Particularly by not getting killed by a super brains and scientist first thing. That's a very good strategy to getting rid of this room. Okay. I'm still low on health, so... Oh, nope, a sunflower will change that. Good, good. Let's go ahead and use the paint to ruin this painting. We're painting a painting. Perfect. Yeah, you got chomped. Yeah, we definitely, we've been chomping a few zombies, that's for sure. Okay. Well, the AI has actually been really proficient here. We only have the dining hall left to get rid of. That's great. Okay, he's retreating. That's fine. I will kill him later when I Geronimo my way in there. Fun fact, the dining hall actually has a nice opening up in its ceiling. Okay. Where are the enemies? I mean, if this is the last chain, I'll take it down. Oh no, actually, that's the last one. I think they're gonna go down simultaneously. Pretty much! And now we've completely crushed their cake. Alright. Gotta be honest, I was in complete disbelief that we would actually win this. It can be so hard for the attacking team at moments. But we actually managed to do it. So, yeah. And you know what? The teammates, the AI, I gotta say, you guys actually did pretty decently. So, hats off to you. I don't usually say this about the AI, but they actually played quite well this time. Alright. I mean, I don't know what to really call this except for a successful mission. Yeah, we had some bumps. We had some casualties. Like every time I tried to use Husk Hop, it usually works. I'm telling you, Husk Hop usually works. But for some reason, it worked out a little differently this time. Don't know why. So, with all that said, that's basically the end of the episode. Wow, it's a half hour episode too. Usually, when I've noticed some things. When I'm recording PVZ, it usually only goes on about 20 minutes, but this time it just went for like half an hour. To be fair, Turf Takeover, not sure if you really noticed, it can take a lot longer than the other modes, and I think that's why it's a little unpopular for some of the PVZ community. There are a lot of people here that play this game who don't actually like Turf Takeover. Like, I'm pretty sure... Not sure I've mentioned this guy before, but Wolfie Plays, he's actually made quite a few videos on this game, but he does not really like Turf Takeover that much. And I think one of the reasons is because there is a certain culture. Like, Turf Takeover is its own subculture. There are certain ways and certain procedures that tend to be followed by a lot of people. Not all of them are good. There are some playstyles that I could talk about, like, say, Citroen Ballers, that are exclusive to Turf Takeover. And honestly, I'll have to probably talk about some of those weird playstyles that can pop up in this game at a later point. But for now, I hope you all have a good day. Consider liking and even better, subscribing. That's the best you can do to help out. And I'll see you in the next video. Toodles!